Good afternoon and welcome to Tuesday's edition of Warrior Daily. My name is Justin Arbogast here with Coach David Greer of men's basketball. And Coach, tough week. We haven't had to do this, talk about a pair of losses, but talk about the games against Northwood and Saginaw Valley.
You know, really, you got to give Northwood a lot of credit. I mean, you know, Northwood's a very talented team. Mm-hmm. They returned four starters, and their sixth man is a young man is very capable of being a starter, and you know, they're a really good basketball team, and they rebound the ball really well, and they got good inside play, which is our weakness, and you know, they just took it to us. We really didn't execute very well, didn't shoot the ball. They shot extremely well. I didn't think our defense was that great, but you know, it wasn't that bad. They just shot extremely well, and consequently, we took one on the chin. And Saginaw Valley, you know, they just you know, you got to give them a lot of credit. They just hung in there. We had a chance to open the game up a couple times. We were up 13 and had some guys get into foul trouble there. We had three guys with two fouls there at halftime and that didn't play the last 4 minutes. And that was an opportunity for us to open the game up, and we didn't. And they had a young man, Bozeman, just went crazy. I mean, he just shot the ball extremely well, and we were literally trying to guard him. And you know, he still poured in 35. I thought Ian Larkin's play was outstanding. He had 28 points in 22 minutes, and we could have just kept him on the floor, you know. But he fouled out. Gerald fouled out, and not having those guys on the floor the last 4 or 5 minutes of a game is really tough for us.
Yeah, it seems like, because especially with the way that the team has played this year, closing out games has been a very strong suit for you. But when you lose those guys, that makes things a little more difficult. Talking about the play of Ian Larkin, you mentioned the 28 points and the 22 minutes that he did have. That kind of seemed to be when you guys were really hitting all cylinders, is when Ian really started to get his offensive game going and you guys were really, really starting to hit your stride. So talk about the importance of Ian. How important is his play to this team as a whole, working things inside and outside?
Well, Ian is a versatile player. You know, he can step out and shoot the three, but lately he's been going inside, which is a pleasant surprise, and his ability to get to the free throw line, he's a good free throw shooter, but you know, teams are starting to switch out on him a lot and try to take some of those things away, which is, you know, the great part of about the second time around. Teams start to make adjustments from the first time. And so we just got to do a better job of getting him more touches. You know, Ian is a really unselfish player. He's not going ball hog or anything like that. He's, you know, if a man's open, he'll give the ball up. And, you know, I'm constantly on him about being a little bit more aggressive offensively. But certainly we're going to need his play down the stretch. And him and Gerald works really well there together in the post, and we just got to make sure we get him a little more touches.
All right. And then coming up on Thursday, we have a couple of interesting things. One, it's a Comcast game again, so on Xfinity Channel 900, you can check that one out from home. But we do also encourage the fans to come out because we are celebrating breast cancer awareness, a very important initiative for Wayne State. And so talk a little bit about that whole process and how you guys really enjoy being involved in something like that.
Well, you know, it's an initiative through the women's basketball program, but, you know, certainly, you know, all of us have been touched in some way by cancer, you know, whether it's someone we know, someone in our family. And certainly it's, you know, it's celebrated this month. And obviously all the teams in the GLIAC take part in it. And we certainly enjoy doing it. You know, we'll be part of that celebration. And me and my wife, we constantly run in the Susan B. Komen Race for the Cure. And here in Detroit, I don't know whether it's run or walk, but we give it our effort, and it's certainly, like I said, something that's dear to all of us, and we certainly encourage the fans to come out and be part of it.
Yeah, absolutely. It's going to be a great event, and I mean, there will be a lot to celebrate and things of charitable efforts and all that, but we also have some very, very big games coming up, especially Thursday, the Michigan Tech game for you guys. It was a very hard-fought battle for you guys up at Tech. I remember being up there. Ali Hader was amazing. He's going to be tough again to keep off the boards and, you know, keep out of the score sheet. But talk about that game as a whole, and then moving forward on Saturday, another big one with Northern as well.
Well, they're all big now down the stretch. You know, we got quite a few teams that are jockeying for playoff spots. You know, you got teams in the South, and you got teams that are trying to host a tournament. Teams are trying to get in the tournament, and certainly Tech has played outstanding ball. They played a great game against Grand Valley on Saturday. They're a very well-coached team, and again, like you said, Ali is a beast down there, and you know, but it's not only him. They shoot a high percentage from the field. They're like I say, they're hungry. We beat them on their home courts. I know they would like nothing better than to come in here and beat us, but you know, at this particular time, you know, we need to play with a lot of more energy and a sense of desperation, because you know, I told our guys, you know, it's it's this time of year that you want to be playing for something, and certainly we are playing for something on Thursday, so it'll be a great game. And then Northern's played really well. You know, Tech was, you know, riding high, and they went into Northern, and Northern upset them, and Northern, you know, played Grand Valley tough last week and certainly gave us a tough ball game up there. So it's a team that, you know, is trying to find his stride a little bit. Coach Lewis, like I said, is his second year, and he's done a great job. And certainly is not a team that we can overlook, but we'll try to get after them also.
All right. Well, a big weekend nonetheless for the Warriors. A few good things to point out. We do have, as we mentioned, the Valentine's game is the breast cancer awareness. And then again, we will have, you know, even more action on Saturday against Northern, which will be a very big team for both squads. So be sure to check that out at the Mathite. That's going to do it here today for Coach David Greer on Warrior Daily.